It is suspected that this fire started at around 4 a.m. in one of the stores at Nakawa Market before it spread to other stores. It is estimated that over 120 market vendors lost their merchandise, which included cereals, fresh fruits, vegetables, among other things. Some of the eyewitnesses narrated how the fire started.
According to the boy, my boy who sleeps here, he was like, just had a fire burned from behind. He didn't know how and where it started. By then, it has already reached him.
Received a call from the vendors here that fire had gutted this market and it was destroying it. It was putting it down. Immediately, I got in touch with the police, and they responded very quickly. They came. We joined hands together with the police and the people who work from here, and we thank God that we've been able to put down the fire.
Although the cause of this fire is still unknown, some people have attributed it to the leadership clashes in the market that recently saw the arrest and detention of the market chairperson, Joseph Mudasi.
This has happened at the time when even the chairman of the vendors is under arrest, is detained in Uzira prisons for reasons which are not known to us, but we think it is harassment, it is intimidation. There are some people who want to take over the market by force, and this one we shall not really agree with it. It's not acceptable at all.
Katale muka agala, jesonga muta andise, ngawe tuwa udilanga mwawino, biasoka wevitu.
Nakawa West Member of Parliament and Leader of Opposition in Parliament, Joel Senyonyi, who visited the scene, called upon the police to do thorough investigation into the case of this fire.
This particular section, I'm told, has had about 120 people that have been affected. The fire started in the wee hours of the morning and has gutted the entire place. There's a lot of speculation. Some are thinking this was deliberate by arsonists, because apparently some people have wanted this section and so on. There's a lot of talk. I've spoken to this police CID operations, Afande Tugume, and asked him and his team to expedite the investigation so that we get to know what exactly caused this fire.
Senyonyi also recommended the formation of a committee to handle the issue and also registered the affected vendors. He called upon any person with any form of relief items to donate to the affected vendors to enable them resume their work.
All of us who are able to bring in something to assist them, they need to put back their structures and so on. We might not do everything, but at least a shot in the arm to assist them to, you know, get off the ground. And then we see how things go. So hopefully that committee is going to be in place today so that we start off.
The affected vendors have appealed to the government to at least provide them free iron sheets so that they can put up temporary structures they can operate in. Meanwhile, police have commenced investigation into this fire.
We registered the fire outbreak at Nakawa Main Market, part of the market. The Fire Prevention and Rescue Services rushed at the scene and managed to put out this fire, so it did not spread through the whole market. We have not yet established what could have caused this fire, but I want to inform you that no injuries were registered and no one has lost their lives because of this fire. However, we know that a lot of people have lost their property, and we are trying to establish the extent of the damage.
Story compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.